Are you tired of the same old pro wrestling? Then check out the amazing action on powerslam.tv, the biggest indie pro wrestling channel in the world. Get over 4,000 hours of the best pro wrestling events from over 110 of the biggest names in the industry from over 15 countries around the globe. Get your free trial today at powerslam.tv.
Hey, this is the National Treasure, Nick Aldis, and you're listening to the All Night Long Wrestling Podcast.
It's the All Night Long Wrestling Podcast with the Enforcer.
I believe they're called Enforcers, Gordon.
I sell women's shoes.
And the Stallion.
Stallion, baby!
I am not what you would call a handsome man.
I'll kick you in the nuts and you'll smile at me and like it.
All night!
Welcome back to another edition of the All Night Long Wrestling Podcast. We are your host, he's a Stallion, I'm the Enforcer. We are coming back with our second episode this week, Joe. We're a couple of guys that have a lot of free time on our hands, and we're able to fit these shows in the drop of a hat. That's not the case. It's like midnight Western Standard Thailand time, and here we are, man. Another show. Yesterday we welcomed independent star Davey N to the show. She we touched on a lot of stuff, but most controversially the debate over Officer Magnum. We can get to that at a later date, but it still doesn't sit well with me, Joe. You know, I Officer Magnum's a big part of the All Night Long Wrestling Podcast, and that kind of a little bit of a thorn in my side, if you will. But we do appreciate Davey N stopping by. It was a great interview. If you get a chance, head on over to our YouTube and subscribe while you're there to check it out first and foremost. And but today it's all about the WWE. Please don't wait. Don't turn it off. Do not turn off the show. It's not just about SummerSlam. It's going to be like 80% NXT, 6% SummerSlam, 14% Joe killing himself on the air. So we're going to start with NXT Takeover, and then we're going to go to SummerSlam, and then. Are you going to stick your head in the oven this week, Joe, or next week?
You just let me know if you want me to do it this week, and then I'll just go preheat the oven so it's ready.
I appreciate you preheating it so it's at an ample temperature for us to just stick our head in the oven. All right, so without further ado, let's get to the show. NXT TakeOver Toronto comes to us from Canada. Yeah, Calgary, Alberta, Canada. And we're looking at 5 matches on the show. 4 of them are title matches, so let's start with the non-title match. First match on the show, we have Candice LeRae versus Io Shirai. Joe, I'll let you take this one.
I think that this should be a win for Io Shirai just because this feud is kind of just beginning. And, she just freshly turned heel last month. So I think that Io Shirai getting a victory here is the way to start this feud. So I'm going to go with heel Io.
I love Io's pizza. I'm starving, by the way. However, I'm going to disagree with you vehemently because Candice LeRae does not seem to win anywhere. She's been getting her butt kicked for what seems like years in NXT, and I think she needs a big win here, and I think Shayna Baszler is going to need a new babyface challenger. So I'm going Candice LeRae in the opener. I just hope it's a really good match. Shirai is super talented. Candice LeRae is, no joke, probably the best in the world at what she does, and I'm really looking forward to this match. Next up, we have a triple threat match. It's not elimination, right? It is a triple threat. I couldn't find that.
I believe it is triple threat, yes.
Yeah. So it's not a three-way dance, unfortunately. However, but champion Velveteen Dream takes on Peter Dune and Roderick Strong for the North American title. I'm going to make this short and sweet. Peter Dune is not from North America, so he's out. Velveteen Dream does not need the title. He's out. Roderick Strong is amazing, and the Horseman of 2019 will ride at NXT TakeOver Toronto. So for me, your winner and new NXT North American champion, Roderick Strong.
Yeah, I agree with you on that. I think that, you know, they... I don't see Pete Dunne winning it, like you said. He kind of just got thrown into the match later on. I don't know if there's a reason for that. Maybe we'll find out, but I don't see him winning it. Dream has had the title for most of the year, which has really been good for him. Maybe it's time for him to elevate up to the NXT title at some point soon. We'll see. But I think the whole story of the Undisputed Era winning all the titles in NXT, or at least all the men's titles in NXT, is something that they should go with. So I will go with Roderick Strong as well to win the title on Saturday.
Next up, we have the Street Profits versus our buddies Bob and Kyle. The team formerly known as Red Dragon, one half of the Undisputed Era. Joe, I know you feel very, very strongly about what's been going on with the Street Profits, so I'm just going to let you take this one real quick.
Well, I mean, generally, I guess as far as the match is concerned, I think it is a little early for the Street Profits to lose the title since they just won it back in June. But, you know, again, I guess I'm going to go with the story of the Undisputed Era winning all the titles. And you know, maybe it'll lead to, well, there's going to be a War Games match come November. So I don't know exactly who's going to be on the babyface side of that. But I'm going to guess that it's going to eventually tie into that somehow. So I'm going to say that Undisputed Era also will win the tag titles on this show and continue that reign into the winter.
Okay, here's the deal. As Joe pointed out in his Shooting with the Stallion segment probably 2 or 3 weeks ago, the Street Profits have been ruined on Monday Night Raw. Vince McMahon has made them Crime Time 2.0. They are not taken seriously, which is unfortunate because they're great. They've only gotten better. Big fan of Dawkins. Big dude. He can move. They're really good. Wrestlers, they're very charismatic. We were there when they won the title. The crowd loved it. They went crazy. That being said, let Bob and Kyle take it from here. The greatest team on God's green, Red Dragon, aka the Undisputed Era, are your new reigning, defending NXT Tag Team Champions. Next up, we have champion Shayna Baszler as she defends her title against she defends her NXT women's title against Mia Yim. Listen, Joe, I'm going to be very honest with you. I've picked against Shayna Baszler for probably the last 3 years. I am 0 for the century. The rumors say Fox Sports wants Shayna Baszler as their figure piece of the women's division. That's what I read. I don't know. I am going to pick Shayna Baszler. Reverse psychology. I'm picking Shayna, pulling for Mia, but picking Shayna because I want to reverse the juju that I've been dealt here. So Shayna Baszler is still your champion, Joe.
Yeah, I've kind of learned the same lesson with picking against her. I used to try to put a lot of thought into her feuds and who would beat her. And then I think earlier this year, I just kind of stopped and I keep picking Shayna to win. And most of the time she does. So I don't know if Mia Yim is going to win the title here. I guess I would expect her not to anyway, if I was really putting thought into it. So I'm going to take Shayna anyway. And hopefully she won't win. But, you know, I think that...
That's very, very honest, very hot take right there.
Yeah, but I think that's what's going to happen. I think she will win, so I'm gonna say Shayna Baszler retains.
Okay, two guys trying to reverse our osmosis here. Main event is... Okay, let me see if I got this right. So the main event of the night is champion, NXT champion Adam Cole defending his title against Johnny Gargano in a 2 out of 3 falls match, or what they used to call a 3 stages of hell match. With no announced third stage. The first fall is a regular standard classic match. The second fall is a no DQ match. And then the third fall, if it goes 3, is going to be up to Commissioner William Regal. I cannot imagine Johnny Gargano winning the title back right now, nor should he. Adam Cole should reign and defend the NXT title until I'm dead. There's probably no better champion. He's great. The Undisputed Era is great. The only thing I have that I wrote down here in my notes, very, very big fan of the note-taking. I can't imagine Gargano winning the title unless something crazy happens. And that, to me, that crazy thing would be Roderick Strong not beating Velveteen Dream and then turning on Adam Cole and the Undisputed Era. I don't see it happening. I hope we're past that. They don't need to break up. They could reign supreme forever. But, yeah, I think in a crazy swerve here, I think the third fall, Joe, is going to be a first blood match. And I think Adam Cole's going to win.
Okay. Yeah, very – that's interesting. I've been wondering, I guess, what that third fall will be, obviously making the assumption that it will go three falls because I figure
– imagine if it doesn't. Sorry. Imagine if it's just a big old swerve and there is no third fall. Like, what a letdown.
Yeah. But I think that Adam Cole will win as well. It's just, you know, he needed the title for a while. He finally got it back in June when we were in Bridgeport. And like you said, I think Gargano either has to move on to something else, whether that's outside of NXT or some other feud. I think it's, you know, it's time for him to do something different. And Adam Cole retaining is definitely the move. I don't know what the third fall is going to be. I really don't. Part of me thinks maybe Regal will make it a submission match or something just to see if that would favor Gargano and, you know, Cole will find a way to pull it out. I'm not really sure. But
question about that. I was thinking about that, too. I don't want to cut you off. There's a submission match on SummerSlam. Natalya and Becky. I remember recently, it was like a year ago, they had a match scheduled and they got switched because they were doing the same match the night after.
I think the NXT. It was a last man standing or something like that.
Okay.
They were going to, I think it had something to do with Styles and Nakamura maybe doing a last man standing and they changed.
Okay.
Something in NXT, something along those lines. Yeah.
What are the options? Really, what could be the option for the third fall?
Well, it's what, straight match and then a no DQ match. So they could do, they could do submission. They could do last man standing. They could do, ladder match, Texas bull rope, perhaps.
Or, I don't know. Coal miner's glove.
Coal miner's glove. Judy Bagwell on a pole. I don't know, man. There's a lot of things. I don't know what Commissioner Regal has up his sleeve. Cage. They could lower a cage down if they have a cage up in the arena.
They could announce the show like that. Like, they could start the show with Regal. Like, the lights are dim. You turn. Maybe Hell in a Cell. Get crazy with it. Just announce a Hell in a Cell match out of nowhere. This has to be the end. True or false, Joe? This has to be the end of the Adam Cole, Johnny Gargano feud.
Yeah, it should be. They've been feuding since just before WrestleMania. So it's been mostly, 5 months or so, I guess, ever since the Ciampa injury happened. Yeah, this is their third match in the series. You figured they were going to do a third one because they split the first two matches, and this is it. So I think that both guys will go in different directions after this show on Saturday.
I'm looking forward to NXT Takeover. I think it's a pretty strong card. I'm surprised there's no Riddle Bro. You know, there's a lot of people I feel like that are left off this card. But I don't know. It's surprising. Matt Riddle was kind of the in thing. You think this whole Goldberg heat kind of pushed him to the back burner?
I don't know. I don't know about that. I'm not sure. I think they stretched out maybe their plans for him, is what I had heard, in terms of maybe they're just trying to keep him fresh and winning matches on the side. Did they change it, or are there the finals of that breakout tournament supposed to be on this show also?
Well, Joe, that's an excellent question, because the old Wikipedia that I was looking at did not have the finals of the breakout show, but I could tell you right now. Have you been watching the breakout tournament?
I have been watching it, yes, and the final, I believe, is Cameron Grimes versus Jordan Miles, a.k.a. Trevor Lee versus ACH, but I have been watching the matches on NXT Weekly in that breakout tournament, and I've been a little underwhelmed, to be honest, but I guess we can, that's a separate topic for another time.
That is a separate topic for another time, but I'm looking at two cards here. I'm not saying it's not possible, but let me look at the official WWE card. Yeah, it's not on there.
Okay, so maybe they decided to take it out. That's fine.
It was on there for a while, right? I'm not crazy.
I thought they had said like the winner and it would be a takeover and the winner would get like a title shot of their choosing. So maybe they either maybe I misremember or maybe they changed it. But that's fine. So we can move on to SummerScam.
I'm sorry, what?
SummerScam. Summerfest.
Oh. Summerfest, that's what it was. Joe, before we move on to Summerfest, you look like you're a little exhausted right now. Is it safe to say you've had a long day?
It's been a long day, Mike.
Joe, if I were you and I had those please take one tickets outside of my bedroom door like you do, I would also look like that. I would look tired. I would look exhausted. I would look like there's nothing left in my body. And do you know why? It's because of our friends over at Blue Chew. You've heard all the deals. You've heard that it's $5 shipping and handling and your first order is free. What does that get you? That gets you all the stuff that the little blue pill, the Viagra, the Cialis, all in a chewable form. All you got to do is you got to head over to bluechew.com. You got to use our promo code WPP. I'm trying to think of an anagram for that, but it's not going to be politically correct. So WPP, $5 is all you're going to pay shipping and handling, and you get your first order of Blue Chew on the house. It works in 30 minutes or less, and listen, it takes out all the bad stuff about having to get the blue pill, I would assume. You don't got to go to a doctor. You don't got to pick things up. And, you know, in just a couple of short days for that $5, you can look as tired as the Stallion is because, let's just say there was a Groupon to take rides on the Stallion this week. And, you know, it was redeemed quite a lot by some lovely local ladies. So kudos to you, Joe. I appreciate you really powering through. I know it was a Gatorade and a turkey sandwich. You know, right back in the game, baby.
Doing the best I can, buddy.
I appreciate you. Speaking of people that are not doing the best they can, let's head on over to SummerSlam. Your SummerSlam card, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 10 matches, much better than last year's 47 matches. Listen, we're going to go match by match. We're going to give our predictions, but we're not going to go too deep into it because, frankly, I haven't watched SmackDown or Raw in probably 3 months. I've been following the storylines, and the best part about the great video package that WWE does on their pay-per-views gives me all I need to know. So I've been reading up on it. I've been reading the results, reading reviews. So let's get into it. However, something I am following, the opening match on SummerSlam 2019 is the Honky Tonk Man with an open chair. No. Wait a second.
Don't spoil anything for me. I don't want to know who's going to answer that challenge.
No, it was a lug nut. Sorry. Champion Drew Gulak defending his Cruiserweight title against Oney Lorcan. Joe, true or false on the spot? Match of the night.
Very well could be, yeah. It's very, very likely. I know Oney had recently...
Rules? You know Oney Rules?
Oney Rules, yes. I know he recently earned a number one contendership for this title. I would like to see these guys wrestle a lot more in the future. I'm going to say that Gulak will find a way to retain the title on this show, and hopefully they'll have some more good matches to come after that.
I'm with you 100%. Drew Gulak wins. Gulak for a better 205 Live. Gulak for a better WWE. And Gulak for a better Combat Zone. Next up, Goldberg versus Ziggler. Goldberg wins. What do you got?
William Goldberg.
Next up, it's a Legends reunion here. Trish Stratus versus Charlotte. Trish Stratus passes the torch that Charlotte took 4 years ago. Charlotte wins, Joe.
Yeah, the only reason they should have this match is to put Charlotte over, right? So in Canada, I guess, even with Trish losing in Canada, I don't know. Whatever. Charlotte wins.
Finn Balor versus the Fiend, Bray Wyatt. Joe, Bray Wyatt wins.
Bray Wyatt wins. I hope Finn Balor goes away and loses his smile.
Dude, why? That was that wasn't shooting with the Stallion, but it's a hot take. What's your problem with that?
He smiles too much. Him That's and fair. Jordan Miles.
I was just going to say.
Really bad.
Next up, Kevin Owens versus Shane McMahon. Kevin Owens wins, Joe.
Yes, Kevin Owens should win this match definitively.
Finally, we get to a decent match on the card. Bayley versus Ember Moon for the SmackDown Women's title. What do you got for me?
I'm going to go with Bayley. I don't know. I just don't know if they really have any legit challengers for Bayley at this point. I mean, it's nice that she's getting a decent title run. I mean, that's cool for her. Ember Moon, I just feel good. So, Bayley.
I guess I'm going to go with the switch up here. I'm going to go with Ember Moon. Bayley's done a good job, but I feel like Sasha Banks is going to be waiting in the wings. I feel like that's something that's going to happen. She's like, she's going to come back sooner rather than later. All this internet BS and whatever. Next up, boy, man, I'm not trying to be that guy, and please don't take it that way, but just looking at this card top to bottom, it's bad news, Joe. It's bad news. Let's get to a decent match. Champion AJ Styles defending his title against his U.S. title against Ricochet. It should be a good match. Is it safe to say AJ's slowing down a bit, Joe?
I think so. I think that's safe to say. They did just put the club, the OC, back together. You know, I don't know. I think the better way to approach this program would be to have AJ find a way to retain by some sort of nefarious means on this show here, and then maybe have Ricochet win at another show or two down the line. You know, put a little bit more strength behind the OC and give them a little bit of a run for a couple months here. So I'm going to go with AJ.
I'm going to agree with you. Speaking of giving strength to the OC, it's good that they're on the show then, right?
The Raw Tag Team Champions? Yes.
Are they wrestling the Revive? No.
I have no idea.
They're not. Okay, next up we have... let's go with champion Becky Lynch defending her title, Raw Women's title, against Natalya in a submission match. Call me crazy. I'm going with the upset here. And I think Natalya is going to get the win over Becky. I don't know how... But maybe Vince is going to give the Canadian fans one here, because it looks like, you're right, Trish Stratus isn't going to win in Canada. Natalya winning in Canada would be a really cool moment. She's been there forever. She's been through – I can't curse, right? No? Okay. She's been through literally some of the worst garbage. She had the flatulence angle. Give the girl a break. Give her the title in Canada. Do the right thing by her. I'm going Natalya.
I have to say, I am definitely rooting for Natalya pretty significantly in this. I would like to see her win the title in Canada. I am curious to see how the crowd will be for the match, because obviously Becky is pretty popular, but Natalya is from Canada, so I don't really know how they're gonna root. But I feel like Becky is going to win, but I am pulling very heavily for Natalya, so I hope that Natalya wins and that you are right.
I mean, I don't think there's anybody that deserves it more than Natalya. She's been through the divas garbage. She's been through this. She's been through the stupid thing. She's been there forever. Let her have her moment. And then do whatever you want. But let her have her. Give her like the Zack Ryder treatment if you want. I don't care. Let's go to the WWE title. Champion Kofi Kingston defends his title against Randy Orton. I have such little use for this match that I want you to go first.
I guess the my understanding of the way that they've been building it up is they've been referencing their feud from like 10 years ago. I think that Kofi's held the title a lot longer than I expected him to. But agreed. I don't think it just doesn't feel like they would be putting it on Orton here. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. I think what they should do is have Kofi keep the title until the first show on Fox, and then have him drop it on that show. I think that would be a good way to kick off the Fox era in October.
Pop a rating, if you will.
Perhaps. I don't know who that person would be that he would lose it to, but either or.
Shane McMahon.
I'm going to say that Kofi retains.
Yep, I'm with you on this one. I think Kofi retains the title. And the main event, champion, Universal Champion Brock Lesnar defends against Seth Rollins. Joe, what's going to happen here? Besides me not watch it.
I'm going to go Brock all the way, baby.
Yep. Brock is definitely going to take it into Fox. And yeah, that's going to be your show. I am wildly underwhelmed at the SummerSlam card. Just looking at it. What do you think?
Well, I guess the good thing is there's only 10 matches. So they decided to cut that down a little bit from prior years. We'll see. I mean, some of the matches have decent storylines behind them, but you know, it's the same thing with all their pay-per-views. Really, it's you know, they can have some good matches on the show, but you know, will the crowd stay invested? I guess the good thing is there's no Baron Corbin, so we don't have to worry about that. But there's also no Braun Strowman. There's also no Drew McIntyre.
No Roman Reigns, Daniel Bryan.
Yeah, so there's a lot of folks that aren't on it. I'm sure, you know, maybe they'll add some stuff or some segments, or somebody will try to, you know, drop a lead pipe on Roman Reigns' head or something like that. I don't really know, man.
All those guys that you mentioned, they're not on it, but Shane McMahon is.
Well, I'm hoping that – I was really hoping they put a stipulation on that where, you know, he would be off TV if he lost, and Owens obviously is supposed to be, you know, fired if he loses. They only seem to – as far as I know, they've only had the one half of it with Owens on it. So maybe this will be the end for the Shane character for a little while. We will see.
I won't see because I'm probably not going to be watching, but the people will see. And listen, why – I wish people could see your face right now. What's the matter? You want to – you? I feel like I'm going to throw a swerve at you. It was going to be the Enforcer's hot take, but I think to pep you up a little bit, I want to get a Shooting with the Stallion segment. But I'm not going to do that right now. We're going to get to that. I want to give people their match of the week last week, and I have a tie, Joe. I've got a tie. First match of the week I literally just watched about 3 hours ago. Shingo versus Tomohiro Ishii. Oh, man. Every single thing you want in a pro wrestling match. If you want two big, thick dudes clotheslining the hell out of each other, punching each other in the face, dropping each other on the head, the crowd's going crazy. It was a phenomenal match. I am so in on Shingo. Ishii has been the MVP of my life. It was been just such a great, I think it was night 16. I don't even, it was last night. So it was August 8th. That was my one match of the week. A one B match of the week is from a couple weeks ago. It is Walter versus Ilya Dragunov from Progress. I think it was 92. Yeah, I think it was Progress 92. Walter defended his title, his Progress world title. Dude, Ilya Dragunov and back-to-back nights put on back-to-back match of the year candidates. The first was Jordan Devlin, which was a match of the week last week, and this week it was against Walter. I mean, it was hard-hitting. You believed Dragunov was going to win that title. Spoiler, he did not. But it was the whole time, it was just the story of Dragunov had Walter's number before Progress. Walter turned into a beast, and Dragunov just couldn't beat him, and it was one hell of a match, Joe. What do you got for us on your match of the week?
I think that maybe in our next production meeting for the show, we should review the criteria for matches of the week. I'm just going to put that out there. So
It was like 9 days ago. Yeah. Is that?
I don't know. What I heard was my match of the week was from a few weeks ago. That's what I heard. I just want to make sure that we can revisit that, you know, out in our next production meeting when we have, you know, all the suits and everybody in there to talk about, you know, our format for the show going forward.
Touché. It was actually from it was July 7th. That's, you know what? Here's my new thing. I watched it this week. It's my match of the week.
Well, that's the thing. That's my new rule. That's what I wanted to. I figured we could talk about, you know, what the criteria is. If it's something that we've watched this week, has the match occurred this week? You know, that's what I figured we can workshop that.
Workshopped it on there. If you watched it this week, I don't care if it was from 1965, it's your match of the week. Okay.
So I can put Jake Roberts versus Rick Rude as my match of the week if I want to do that?
Dude, I'm sold. Do it.
Okay, all right. My real match of the week is going to be the Briscoes versus Dragon Lee and Roosh from ROH TV. I would check that out if anybody has subscription to Honor Club or gets Ring of Honor Television via their cable subscription. It was a very solid main event on ROH TV this past week. So,
It's funny you brought up the Briscoes, because if you're sitting here and you're watching the show and you're saying, Enforcer, what the hell do I watch this week? There's so much great wrestling on. Ring of Honor, Honor Club, tomorrow night, Summer Sizzle, Spectacular, Big Bash. Not sure the name of the show. However, Briscoes versus the G.O.D. in a ladder war. We were front and center for the Manhattan Mayhem match that was not a ladder war. And everybody almost died. Kind of like Lance Archer, everybody dies. That match, was unbelievable. Mark Briscoe took some of the craziest bumps. The crowd was so hot for it. I am so excited for tomorrow. It has to be the blow for the feud, and I would assume that's the end of GOD and Ring of Honor. But the Briscoes have to win tomorrow night, and it's going to be an amazing match. So for me, what to watch for this week is Ladder War tomorrow night. Briscoes defending the Ring of Honor tag titles against the GOD.
Yeah, and I guess I'll just tack on to that the finals of the G1, right? I mean, that's coming up over the weekend. I think it's going to be maybe Sunday night into Monday. So there's two more shows left in the regular part of the tournament, night 17, night 18. And then the finals will be, I believe, on the 12th, which is Monday. So between the Ring of Honor tomorrow night, as you mentioned, and then NXT Saturday, SummerSlam on Sunday, there's a couple of G1 cards mixed in there, and then the finals on Monday. So I'm going to say I'll throw that in for additional viewing pleasure.
That's a great call. I'm looking forward to that as well. The other thing I want to let everybody know is if you hear me talking about these progress matches and you're like, man, I always wanted to get into progress. I hear all these things. WWE is poaching talent from progress for NXT left and right. I want to see where these guys came from. I, the enforcer, have news for you. Powerslam.tv. You're going to go ahead and use our promo code, ours. It's all night long. You get your first 30 days of Powerslam.tv for free. Do you know how much wrestling you could watch in 30 days? You could watch Progress Chapter 1 through 93 and be caught up and talk progress with us. Powerslam.tv. Use your promo code all night long and make sure you tweet us and let us know you did. Powerslam.tv, those guys are really good. They have so many different programs on there. I can't list them all. You have CZW, has some old Evolve stuff. You've got Progress, OTT, which is Joe's new favorite promotion. So much going on. Powerslam.tv. Use promo code all night long. And now, before you click subscribe and before you go to our social media and you type at All Night Long WP and you like, you rate, you review, you subscribe, you do everything you can. You go to facebook.com/All Night Long Wrestling Podcast. You go to youtube.com/All Night Long Wrestling Podcast. You put us over everywhere. You click like on all our videos. Before you do that, before I let you go, before I tell you that we're tapping out, before anything, right now, we're shooting with the Stallion.
I'm on the spot. Well, I have to tell you, Mike, there's a lot of things that enrage me on a daily basis. Get into my skin. I have to admit that. I like to watch as much wrestling as I can in my free time. So I do spend time watching all the stuff that we talk about, like the G1, NXT, ROH, OTT. But I do still watch the main roster product in as much as I possibly can. Mostly Raw, I admit, right? The shoot of it is I watch Raw, and I really don't see SmackDown. I have to tell you that after several months of watching Monday Night Raw, I am severely irritated by Becky Lynch. I have had more than enough of this woman on TV every single week. She seems arrogant. Overconfident. She does things that I feel a heel would do, and I really don't care about her stupid CrossFit boyfriend Seth Rollins. I don't need to hear about that on TV every week. I'm tired of her crap, and I guess just to follow up on my point from earlier, I am rooting for Natalia heavily to win the Raw Women's title on Sunday and make Becky Lynch tap out or pass out somehow to the Sharpshooter. That is my Shooting with the Stallion segment for this week.
The 1980 men's Olympic hockey team, the 1994 New York Rangers beating the Vancouver Canucks, the 1995 Dallas Cowboys beating the Pittsburgh Steelers, and Matt Serra knocking out George St. Pierre. Those events were the hardest I've celebrated personally until that segment right there, that Shooting with the Stallion. That was the best segment ever. I could not agree with you more. I'm totally with you about CrossFit Jesus, Seth Rollins, I agree with everything you say, and you know I've been on Team Natalya. Joe, tell the people, how long have I been on Team Natalya?
You've been a staunch Natalya supporter for many years.
I've been championing Natalya Neidhart. I am so happy you said what you said. This is the best episode of the All Night Long Wrestling Podcast ever. We're going to end this show on a high note. Thank you, everybody, for listening. Again, at All Night Long, WP, everywhere you go. Tomorrow night, depends when you listen to this, Friday night, I should say, I'll be live tweeting the Ring of Honor show, and we'll be live tweeting during the NXT show. I also want Joe's hot take to be tweeted out during SummerSlam. So, if you do stay awake for the entire SummerSlam show, I want to hear about it, of that Becky Lynch and Natalya Neidhart match. For the Stallion, I'm the Enforcer. Another edition of the All Night Long Wrestling Podcast is in the books, and we are tapping out.